right? Let's turn this volume down a little bit. Let's play it. Okay, I'm not in sample mode, so yep. Not hearing anything. Make sure that's in there correctly now. Something is coming through, or you wouldn't get those lines. See those lines pumping across? I mean, something's coming through. Why am I not getting it on the out? Figured it out. Okay, so we figured it out. Forgot to press this twice. Gotta have it red and yellow to get it coming out so you can hear it. Okay, we're also, well, see that? That dot, it might be hard to see. There it is, dot. Let's go ahead and press this back. It's at the start. Okay. Now, we're gonna hit record, right? And then I'm gonna play it. We're gonna stop right there. Do it again. Okay. Now, that's done, right? Let's stop that recording. Stop it, right? Now it's asking me for a root key. Put it here. Now let's listen. Remember I stopped it. Okay, that was from the computer. So was that. I think I'm good. It's sounding on point. No detuning. Yeah. Yeah. No detuning. I likes that. We're gonna go forward. I'm gonna chop some of that out. Start off with 10. Let's go to. That's it. So the sample's on point. Let's play it again. Remember, my computer, because of the fact that the way I have a network here at the house, so anytime I'm on Winamp, it'll take like a second. The song kind of like pauses for a second because of how my network is. I really need to fix that. I just haven't had time to, and I just haven't cared enough yet to do that. Let's play it. That's the first time my computer did that. Second time. Sounds like we got a good recording. No detuning. This was very successful. Yeah, I know a lot of people are going to be like, the sample was whack. I wasn't really going for a good sample. This was more about me repairing the ASR, fixing the bugs that were inside, and making sure. Yeah, see Elmo. Yeah, I need to do something about that room there. But this was more about repairing the ASR-10. This wasn't about really sitting down and saying, okay, how can I figure things out or whatever. It's not what this was about. This was about repairing the ASR. A couple of things I want to say. Tissue paper. I have a lot of it. See that? I don't know if you can see that. See that brown stuff in there? That stuff that's just coming off the ASR-10. A lot of that's not from keys. More tissue. Bags of tissue. Remember, anti-static bag. Anti-static bag. Okay? This is mine. This is my anti-static wristband. Very important. Another important piece. Yes, the Family Dollar. You don't have to get the one from Family Dollar, but glass and surface cleaner. Banging. Anything else? Toothbrush. Very important. Went during this process. Let me see. More tissue. Ooh. Gotta have a screwdriver. I actually had more than one head. I had this one. This one's kind of a flat Phillips. Then I had more of a narrow one. Start with this. Tweezers. A couple of times there I had to pull screws out because they didn't go in directly the way I wanted them to. Smaller. This worked with the only used this like maybe four times for four freaking screws. So really one time. But for four different screws. This was for the floppy drive. That's how I got that out. Oh, Radio Shack. Love you, baby. Radio Shack. Let's go over here. Grab a couple of other things. Oh, by the way. Yeah, I got Scuzzy, son. I got Scuzzy. Yes, there be's Scuzzy. I got a couple of things for the ASR-10. Obviously, I know you've seen some floppies. Next thing, dust remover spray. Yeah, I had to buy two of those. They're both really empty.